Ladies and gentlemen, we have pursued God from a homestead God, and now is on his way to the land which will be his land, where he can become a national God. But God knew very well that he's coming into a world where there's so much culture surrounding all activities. We have Abraham's covenant, which promised him a lot of progeny, who will be so powerful and so many that they will be the one to inherit the land. If a God talks like that, I want you to remember that my biggest job here is to give a pre-understanding. If a God talked like that, that showed Abraham that he has a God who is so ambitious that he is out for to become a national God. Otherwise, having kids with no home to where they can call their home, it is a wastage of time. And immediately when the Exodus took place, and in that Exodus, he graduated from being a national God from a homestead God to a national God, he makes another covenant. Now, I would love us to analyze this covenant in the context of the culture of those days. And I want to emphasize, the Bible is full of the of culture, of the people whereby God revealed himself and who are going to be responsible for the composition of many of these traditions which have come out in the wrong run, and they are called Bible. See? The composition which they themselves were sure that God of heaven has revealed himself in a special manner. And a composition which helps us to see how those people responded to God's revelation. It is very important. But I want to assure you that God reveals himself in history. And anything outside history cannot be recorded as a human. A finger has to become human only when it is in the context of human history. And God knows that very well. You see, God knows that very well. He's more than patient with us to make sure that human history and we, the people he wants to communicate to, we are part and parcel. God speaks our language when he communicates to us. He does not speak any other language. You see, when he confronts a Hebrew, he will speak Hebrew. When he confronts an English speaker, he will speak English. He is within history, human history, human culture, human elements which make us human. That's what God uses seriously to communicate to us. Now, let us examine very quickly this idea of the covenant. Is it a terminology of heaven, or it is part and parcel of our culture? There were so many people with the covenants. By the time God becomes a national God, the covenant system, there was always a covenant system. The covenant system was a Hittite system. You see, it was always a Hittite system, kind of the government, Hittite. And what does Hittite mean? The Hittites at that particular time were the first people to, they were among the ancients rather, who used the covenantal system. And when we begin to talk about the covenant, God was borrowing directly from the Hittite system, and he's going to comply with the Hittite system of covenant. God allows the human system, which was made by the uncircumcised people who are not Israelites, to communicate to Israel using that very system. That was for the first time to show that he is not only planning to be a God of Israel alone. Maybe he has bigger issues in mind, bigger things he has in mind. And therefore, we have to examine and analyze what a Hittite covenantal system is all about. I have analyzed it for you in this book, you see. But in case you have some problems, let me summarize it for you to give you a pre-understanding of what a Hittite covenant system is all about. The Hittite covenant system, I have said, was not started by Israel. It was started by Gentiles, you see, a Gentile empire of the Hittites, whereby they made covenants among themselves. And God is going to use that very system, you see, because that's what Moses at that time understood, and that's what Israel at that time understood. Let me caution you carefully. This does not mean that this was the best system. But when God reveals himself, he uses a system which is at that time present for his people to understand him. Israel could understand God more when God employs a Hittite covenantal system. What Hittite covenantal system entail, for example? If an emperor went to war in those days and then conquered lesser kings, you see, lesser states, there was always a covenant between a conqueror and those whom they have conquered. And therefore, the preamble went like this: I am now your master. Yes, sir. Reason? Because I have conquered you. Yes. By military means. Yes. Therefore, I am, you are my vassal king. Yes. Don't have any other boss before me. You see, that's the way the preamble began. You see, it stated the conqueror, and it stated the reason why he should be your boss, or what we do call the suzerain, you know, yes, on top of you, why you should be a vassal king under him. The reason: he has conquered you. I have overcome you, you see. Yes, my armies have overcome yours. And because of that, I deserve to be your leader. Therefore, since I am your leader, you have to abide very much with me and me alone. The moment you begin to pick another leader, I will invade you. I will come and invade you. And because that will be a direct confession that you no longer have confidence in me. And I'll restore that confidence by again winning you or overcoming you.